Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to another 5 Minute Friday with me, international multi-award-winning portrait photographer Jessica McGovern. I basically use these videos to try and share a tip, technique or tool within 5 minutes in a way that's easy to understand for anybody who wants to upskill their photography. Now today's topic is something that I think might be useful, if not now, then definitely in the future. So this video is probably one to save just because you're probably going to need it at some point. Without further ado, let's get started. So today's 5 Minute Friday topic is all about banding, which you'll already know because it'll be in the title. But the important part about this particular video is how to treat banding that already exists inside an image. So, what causes banding? Banding is usually caused by super aggressive editing, pulling a color gamut further than it possibly can go, or by incorrect export procedures, export processes, and formats. So, banding is usually always, 99.9% of the time, caused by you in editing, and therefore the single best way to treat banding is to find where it started and fix it, because fixing it afterwards doesn't actually improve your whole process, and you're gonna have to do this all the time. However, there will be specific times where you're gonna need to go in and fix it. And so that's what we're covering off today. The way to fix banding is really quite straightforward. And we're going to use an image which was submitted by one of our MTOGs, Lisa, today. First of all, where are the bands? For me, it's blindingly obvious where they are. You can see these rings happening through the image, right? Can you see them? These rings are classic banding, okay? So they go all the way across to this lighter area. Image is absolutely freaking gorgeous, so we do want to fix it. Now, how do you see banding if you're not 100% sure? Easiest way is to apply a solar curve adjustment layer, because the solar curve, apart from making things look terrifying, is really good to show very, very obvious bands. So that's how to find banding, but how do we treat banding? Super simple. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna duplicate our background layer, okay? And then what we're going to do is we're gonna go ahead and go up to filter, and we're gonna go into blur, and we're gonna go ahead and choose surface blur, okay? Now, we're gonna start with the radius at 1 and the threshold at around about 18 to 20. You don't have to be too specific. And what we're wanting to do is zoom in, if you can, on an area that has these bands, okay? So I can see these bands super clearly here. Then what I'm gonna do is incrementally drag and let go this surface blur up until I can no longer see any evidence of the original bands. So I'm, to be honest, around about here, which is 15 pixels, but for you, this might be different. Now I've zoomed out and I can see the band still present, so I'm gonna just push it a little bit further along. Let's go to 20. And now I feel confident that I can no longer see the bad bands that we had originally. You may be able to see new lines, right? New lines, don't panic. Leave them, ignore, park them, we're gonna solve it. When you've done that and you've got this setting nailed in, we're gonna click OK. And that's basically set that surface blur to be acting on this layer. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add some noise. Now it's very important to do this step, because if you don't, it doesn't really fix all types of banding. So we're gonna go into filter, we're gonna go into noise, and then we're gonna go into add noise. When we add the noise, what we're wanting to achieve here is a level of noise really that matched the original file, because every image has got noise in it. So 1% is sometimes sufficient, 2% can sometimes match to the original level of noise. I'm gonna go with 1% for this image because it was quite clean to start with. So 1%, and I'm specifically on Gaussian with monochromatic checked, and then I'm gonna click okay. So with that done, then what we need to do is get the dog or the subject, whatever it might be, and also anything in the midground or foreground out of this effect, because at the moment that looks ridiculous. So what do we do? I would always go down to your original background layer, make sure you clicked on that, and then we're gonna do a select, and we're gonna do subject. Then what I'm gonna do is click back onto my layer that I've done my surface blur, my add noise on, and then click the mask icon. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna create a mask which looks like the subject, right? So we're gonna make sure that that mask is clicked on, and then do Command I to invert the mask. That's popped the dog, the subject, out of the effect. So then all that's left to do is grab a brush, I'm going to grab a black brush, so I'm making sure we're on black. If Photoshop's scary for you, there is a video, Photoshop Basics. And then we also do have our Photoshop for Beginners online course. So I'm going to go grab that black brush, make sure we're on 100% opacity and 100% flow. And then I'm going to just go and take out anything that's in the midground or the foreground, right? Midground or the foreground. And what I'm also going to do is drop to about 30% and just whiz around the edge of our subject, just to make sure that we have got all of those little bits popped out, including our little bugs. So what are we left with here? We're left with an image that doesn't have any banding. And if we want to, we can do a solar curve check. There is now no bands, no bands here, none at all, no banding. And so what we've done is we've solved the banding by adding a surface blur and a noise layer. And so guys, it's literally that simple. So what do? We duplicate the layer. We go ahead and add a surface blur. We then go ahead and add noise to that same layer. Then we mask out the subject, the midground, and the foreground. If you don't know what the midground is, anything that's in focus in the image, just whip it straight out. And anything in the foreground is in kind of in front of that towards the camera. So you want to take out of all of that. And then at that point, you should theoretically have solved your banding issue. However, remember, please, guys, go back in your editing and find out where those bands started, because finding where it started means that you will not make that mistake again. And that is far better than doing this fix, however this exists, if you need it. And so that is today's 5 Minute Friday. Hopefully that was helpful for you. Really excited to be back next week with another tip. So if you haven't already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Share this with your friends or photographers or just anybody who might use this, because that would be super. And I'll see you all again really, really soon.